Hey, what's up guys? In this video we are going to create student grade calculator with vanilla JavaScript. So if you're excited to build this project, smash the like button and subscribe to this channel, and also tell me in the comments what you have learned from this video. So without wasting the time, let's get started. So as you see, we have an amazing UI of a student grade calculator. So let's test this app. We can calculate the total marks obtained by the student, the percentage, the grade of the student, and we will also get to know if the student is pass or fail. So let's test this app. So for example, the student has obtained 76 marks in the web development, 44 in math, 66 in the physics, and in chemistry he has 84 marks. So let's calculate its percentage. So as you see, you have obtained 270 marks out of 400 with 67.5% and B grade, and you are pass. And now if the student have less marks, for example, let's say 30, 24, 12, and let's give it 8 marks, let's calculate. Now you will see you have obtained 77 marks out of 400 with 19.25% and F grade, and you are fail. So this is the app that we are going to build. So without wasting time, let's go to our code editor, and I am using Visual Studio Code. You can use any of the code editor that you want. I have a basic setup of files, which are the index.html file, CSS file, and app. I have already import CSS file and my JavaScript file into my index.html file. So without wasting time, let's get started. And all of the code I will upload to my GitHub repository and give the link in the description of this video, so you can download it from my GitHub. So let's get started. So first of all, we will have a container which will contain the card. So let's create a card in the container. Basically, this card is going to be this purple background card, and in this card we will have two parts. The left side will be title, and on the right side we will have inputs. So let's go to code editor. So basically, in this card we will have two containers. The first one will be card dash left dash container. So let's give it a card dash left side, and the other container is going to be card dash right dash side. So basically, in the left container we will have a title with h2 tag. It will be student grade calculator. So let's give the title, which will be student. We want a line break after student grade, and the other one is going to be calculator. So let's save it. And the on the right side, what we will have four input fields. For example, input type is going to be text, and the placeholder is going to be a web development. So the other one is going to be the next step, which will be, let's give physics. So same with the other input fields, we will use a different subjects. For example, chemistry, and the fourth one is going to be, oops, so for the fourth one we will use a different subject, which will be, we will use maths. And at the end we will have a button. The button will have a text of calculate, and the mistake, calculate percentage, So you can only use calculate or whatever text that you want. So I'm using calculate percentage. So let's give the classes and IDs. So basically classes we will use for our CSS file and IDs to import or select them in our JavaScript file. So let's give it a class btn and ID will also be a btn. So let's give the IDs to these input fields. So for web development we will have ID of web. Now for let's see physics we will have an ID of PHY which will be shortcut, and then for chemistry and for maths I think we'll use proper name. Now let's save it, and here you will see we have a let's hit the calculate percentage, and at the end of the card we have a div which will show the result. So let's refresh it. We have a demo text of show result. Let's build this container. So first of all what I will do is I will go outside of the card which will be here. Oops, not here. So I will go outside of the card and here I will create a show result. So let's create a div with an ID of show result, and in this ID we will have a simple p tag. Let's give it an ID of first of all give it an text of show result, and then what we'll do is so instead of giving the ID to the div, let's give the ID to the p tag. So remove it from here, give it to the p tag. Let's save it and now open it with the live server. Now you will see it will not look great, the design is not looking great. So don't worry, we will fix it. So let's go to our CSS file. So first of all what I will do is I will remove the default margin and padding. So for example let's set the margin to 0, padding to 0, and we will set the box sizing to a border box. Let's save it. Now I will target the body. So for body we want a font family of this, and now what I will do, so we also want our container at the middle, so I will use a flex box will be an easy one, display will be flex, justify content will be a center, and line items will also be a center. Let's save it and let's see the result. As you will see we have a text at the middle but it's not at the middle right now. So for this we have to give a height to our body. So let's give it a min height of 100 viewport height. So as you will see now it will become at the middle. So we have to fix some of the alignment because we don't want the input fields in the row direction. We want it in the vertical or column direction. So for this what we'll do is we'll copy the class name of the container. First of all let's fix the container. So I will copy the class name, so let's paste it here, give it a background color of purple. Oops. The text color is going to be a white one. Let's save it and now you will see a change. So what we'll do is we'll target the card and set it to display of flex. Justify content will be space between, and line items is going to be center. Let's save it and now you will see a difference. Now what we have to do, we have to use a flex box to align it in the vertical direction. So let's target the card right side I will go to my index.html file. I will copy the class name. Let's go to CSS file. Let's paste it here. And now we will use display flex. We want it in the vertical direction. So for this, we will use a flex direction of column. So justify content will be space between. And line items is going to be center. Let's save it. Now you will see we have our input fields aligned in a different direction, which is in the vertical direction. So let's go to our style sheet and give a height and width to our container. Let's give it a height of 450 pixels and width of 500. Let's save it. And now you will see we have an amazing looking card. So just reduce the height, I think, to 400 pixel will be enough. Let's save it. Yeah, it will be enough. So what we want to do, we want to use a display flex in the container because we want to align our result at the middle in the vertical direction. So let's go to container display. Oops, not inline grid. We will use display of flex. Flex direction is going to be column. Justify content will be space between, and line items will be center. Let's save it. And now you will see we have a text at the middle. So it's not coming at the middle right now. So what we'll do, we'll use a space around maybe. So let's see. Now you'll see we have a space around the container. Now we will fix this. Let's give the width, or we can say, first of all, we want to get a space between the input fields and the button, and the space between these two sides. So let's go to CSS file, and I will target the input fields, which will be in the card right side. So let's target the card right side. Here we will target the input fields. So we want a margin bottom of, let's see, I think 10 pixels. Let's try. So first of all, we want a margin of left from our card right side. Let's give it a margin left of 2 mm. Let's see if we have a space now. Yeah, so let's increase it into 3 mm. Now it's looking good. Yeah, so the margin bottom is going to be a 1.25 mm. You can test different values and you can try which will look good for you. So now we have a space. Let's give the width to our input fields. So for example, I will give it a width of 200 pixels. Let's save it. Yeah, it's looking good. And we want a padding of 5 pixels from top and bottom and 10 pixels from left and right. Let's save it. Yeah, it's looking good. We want a background color to be white. Let's save it. But we want to reduce the opacity. As you will see, here we have a less opacity. So I will go to the color and we will use the opacity of 0.116 I am using. Let's save it. Now you will see a change. Yeah, here you will see a change. So don't worry, we will fix all of the issues. Just stick together and let's go give the border to none. outline will also be none, and color will be white for the text. Let's save it. Let's give it a font size of 10 pixels. Let's save it. And now you will see if we are writing. I think font size is too low. Let's use a 20 pixel. Oops, 20 pixel may be too much. Yeah, it's looking good. I think we will use something like 16 pixel. Let's save it. And it will look good. And give it a font weight also. So let's give it a font weight of 400 pixel. And it will increase the font weight of the text that we are using. Now what we want to do, we want to show the placeholder just like the demo. So for this, we will go to the input and we will target the placeholder. So for example, in the card right side, we have an input, and in the input, we will target the placeholder. So for the placeholder, we want a color to be white. Let's save it. And now you will see we have a white color. Just increase the font weight, whatever you want. So for example, font weight is going to be a 400 or a 500. Let's save it. And now you will see we have a background color, or we can say a placeholder. So we can just increase the, I think it's looking good, but you can, there is always been improvement that you can do. Let's increase the font size to 16 pixel. Let's see if it will change something. Yeah, it's looking good. So what we want to do is we want to style the button. So for example, in the card right side, we will target the button. We will give it the same width of 200 pixel, and we want a background to be white and the color of the text to be purple. So just set the basic properties of, such as border will be none. We don't choose the border. Outline will also be none. And I think let's save it. Let's set the cursor to pointer so it will be clickable. So for example, set the cursor to pointer. Let's save it. And now you will see it's looking good. We just have to give it a padding. So let's give it a padding of, so for example, I have used padding for the input fields of 5 pixels from top and bottom and 10 pixels from left and right. Let's save it. And now you will see our button is looking good. Just increase the font weight. So font size, font weight is going to be 600. Font size is going to be 16 pixels. Let's save it. And now you will see it's looking good. Yeah, it's looking amazing right now. We just have to fix some of the properties. So for example, we want to give a background color, and we also want to style this heading. So first of all, style the heading. So I will go to index.html file, and I will copy the class name, or we can say card left side. Let's copy the class name, go to style sheet, target it, and we will target the h2 tag here. Because this is the heading, we want to increase the font size to, I think, 2.5 frame will be enough. Let's see. Yeah, it's looking good. I think it's too much. Let's use a 2 RAM. Let's save it. Yeah, it's looking good. Give it a font weight of 700. Let's save it. And what we want to do, we want to give it a border of right. It will be 2 pixel solid white color. Let's save it. Now you will see we have a border right. Just use a 3 pixel. And we also want a padding right because we want a space between the border and the text. So I will give it a padding right of 5 pixel. Let's save it. And now you will see, I think 5 pixels is not enough. Just increase it to 8 pixel maybe. Yeah, we have a space between the border and the title. So what we want to do is, now we want to give a background color to the body. So for a body, I will use a background color. I think so. We will use a background of linear gradient of 120 degree and RGBA, or we can use simple color. Let's see. So we have used a yellow and lime color. So I will use a yellow and lime color. Let's save it. And now you will see we have a same looking background. You can also give a box shadow. So let's go to container, and here we will use a box shadow. So box shadow is going to be, I think so, we want a 0 pixel from in the X, 0 pixel from right. Let's give it a 15 pixel of blur. Now we have a spread value also. So what we'll do is, so just use a 15 pixel maybe. So what I will do, I will copy the box shadow from my other file. So it will be this box shadow, Control C, and now we will use this box shadow. So I will replace it. Let's save it. You can copy it. Now you will see we have box shadow and it's looking amazing. Now the other part of our build is now going to start, which will be the JavaScript part. So as you will see the functionality, we want to run the function when we hit the button. So let's go to add. So first of all, what we'll do is we'll add an event listener on the button, and then we will do a function. So first of all, import the button. So it will be document dot get element by id. So it will be, I think we have used the id of button. And what we want to do is we want to run an event listener on the button. So the event listener will be on a click event. So first of all, what we'll do is we will add an event listener to the button. So let's use a CLIC click, and the function that we want to run on an event listener is going to be calculate, and now create a function. So here I will create a function. I'm using arrow functions. So let's use don't do a spelling mistake. So it will be calculate, then we will use the brackets and or parentheses, and then we will use an arrow, then curly braces. So first of all, what we will do is we will import all of the input fields. So first one will be web, it will be document dot get element by id, and the id is going to be web. So as you see, we just don't want the input fields, we want the values that will be in the input fields. So for this, what we'll do is we will add a value at the end, not a node value. Let's save it. So by using the dot value, we will get the value of the input fields. So the next one is going to be a physics. So I will use the same technique, which will be document dot get element by id. It will be phy, which will be physics, and we will use the value. So web is done, physics is done, the other one is going to be chemistry. So let's select it by using document.getElementById. So the id is going to be the same one, dot value. So the last part is going to be a maths, so it will be document dot get element by id, and it will be maths and dot value. Let's save it. So first of all, what we want is we want to calculate the obtained marks of the student. So I will use let, so it will be obtained marks is going to be, we will add all of the values that we have get from the input fields. So first of all, what we want is we want to use a parsed float, and then we want to add, because the default values that we get is going to be string, so we don't want to add the strings, we want to convert it to numbers. We can also use the parse int, but we are using parse float because the user can also hit a point number such as 39.5 or 50.5 for any other marks. So for this purpose, parse float will be a good option. So the other one is going to be parse float, it will be a physics marks. The third one is going to be chemistry. The last one is going to be a mathematics, which will be a maths. So it will be a maths. So we can also test it by using alert, and it will be obtained marks. Let's save it and go to our project, give the numbers. So let's use some random numbers and hit click the button. Now you will see we are getting the total marks. So we have obtained the total marks. Now we want to calculate the percentage. So for percentage, what we'll do, we will use that percentage. First of all, we will initialize, and then what we want to do, we want, so the formula of percentage is the obtained marks divided by the total marks and multiplied by 100. So the obtained marks is going to be in this keyword, and the total marks is going to be 400 because we have four subjects. And now we will calculate it by multiplying by 100. Now let's test the percentage if we're getting right or not. So I'll use alert. Let's go to our project, give the numbers. So different numbers. So for maths, I will choose 45. Let's calculate. So we are getting 235 marks, and the percentage is going to be 58.75. So we have obtained the total marks obtained. We have also got the percentage, and now what we want to get is, so we have it obtained marks, then we have a percentage. We want to calculate the grade, and we want to set a condition of fail or pass. So let's go to our code editor. So in the app.js file, so let's see. So first of all, remove the alert. We have successfully get the obtained marks and the total marks. Now what we want to do is we want to build a logic of a grade. So we'll use if statement. For example, if the percentage will be less than or equal to 100, and we will use and not or, and percentage is greater than equal to 80, then it will be a grade. So first of all, initialize the grade keyword, which will be this one, and I will set it to empty string. So just give it some space. So let's set the grade to A. So the next part is going to be else if. So for else if, what we want to do, if the percentage is less than equal to 79 and greater than equal to 60, then it will be a B grade. So let's give the grade is going to be a B. Now run an other else if, or else if, and now what we have is if percentage is less than equal to 59 and the percentage is greater than equal to 40, then what we have is we will have a grade of C. So it will be C grade. And now we have another else if, so the percentage, if the percentage is less than equal to 39 and if the percentage is greater than equal to 33, then the student will have a grade of D. Oops, write it in the commas. Else otherwise student will have a grade of F. So the grade is going to be F if the student have less than 33% marks or 33 marks. So the grade is going to be F. Let's save it. So we have got a grade. Now we want to build a logic. So if the student is going to be a, if the student will get a marks greater than 33 or 33%, it will be a pass, otherwise it will be a fail. So let's test. So here is the F grade. So let's build a new logic, which will be if the percentage is greater than equal to, so we can, what we will do is 33. If the student have marks greater than 33, then what we want to do, first of all I will import the show result keyword, show result id. Let's show result is going to be a document dot get element by id. So id is going to be a show result, and we want to change the its inner text. So we'll set the inner html to, so we want to change the inner html, so let's use a template literals. So we can use you have obtained, so the marks is going to be a obtained marks. Oops, obtained marks. So you have obtained the following marks from, or we can say out of 400, with here we will use a percentage. So I will use a percentage with percentage, and now what we will do is we want to use the grade. So this will be the grade, and we can say at the end you are pass, because if the student will have marks greater than 33%, then the student will pass the exams, otherwise it will fail. So the else statement is going to be a fail. As I will use the same control C, we have to do a minor changing, which will be you are fail. So let's save it. And now what we want to do is we will go to our project, and here what we'll do is we'll give the marks some random marks. So let's see. So as I'm hitting, so it's not working right now. So let's see if we have imported. So it will be let's show result. So let's see what is the ID. The ID is going to be this one. So let's
we'll see. So let's see what's happening. Let's paste it here. Let's save it. And now show result is going to be this one. We want to change the inner HTML. So it will be, I think, 400. We have 400 marks. Then the grade. So why it's not working? I think it will work. So let's test the app. Let's refresh the page. Now give a different marks. So we have inner HTML show result. So let's give it some marks. And now let's hit the enter. Let's see what is the bug. Let's go to the console, which will be in the inspect. We will go to the console. So here it will be. Let's hit the enter. So we are not getting any error. So what it will be, I think. So let's use the alert show result dot inner HTML. So what I will do is, I will go to the demo code, and here you will see what we are doing. So we are using the same logic, but it's not working. So what could be the issue? I think so it should work. Let's see. So I think we have some mistake, because we are getting this red curly braces. Why we are getting this? So let's remove it from here. Let's see if it will work or not. I think we are using some extra. So let's give some random values to our subjects. Let's see. So now you will see we have some mistake in the code, which will be the extra curly brace. So as you see, these little mistakes can affect your code. So now you will see we are getting the total marks, which will be you have obtained 180 out of 400. So after 400 we will use the marks. So here is 400 marks, and with the percentage of this, and after grade I will write a grade. Let's see, grade, and we'll use the same logic here. After 400 I will use the marks, because it will show the marks that we have obtained. And after grade I will write the grade word. Let's save it. And now test this. Let's give it different values. Oops. So let's see. Let's hit the enter. So as you see, we are getting, so we want a line break after, maybe I think so, after percentage. Let's do a line break. So here is our percentage, and we will get a line break. So for this I will use the br tag, because it will look good. So let's give a different. So first of all, refresh the page. Now give a different marks or values to the input fields. So whatever you want. Now I will hit the enter. Now it's looking good. So it's saying you have obtained 279 out of 400 marks with 69.75% and B grade, and you are passed. So just do a little bit of change also at the marks at the end of 279, which are the obtained marks. So these are the obtained marks. So here I will also use the keyword of marks. let's save it, go to our project. Now our project is completed. We have obtained the marks. We will use the obtained marks. We will get the percentage. So you have obtained 223 marks out of 400 marks with 55.75% and C grade as your pass. So let's test the other part, which will be if the student is failed. So for example, if the student have less marks, 33, 22, 11, 2, let's hit and now calculate it. Now you will see you have obtained 68 marks out of 400 marks with 17% and F grade and you are fail. So our app is working correctly right now. We can calculate the passing marks or fail marks. We will also calculate the obtained marks obtained by the student, the percentage and the grade, and if the student is pass or fail. So this is the project that we have built. So don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you have learned something from this video, because usually I upload a 3 to 4 projects weekly on my YouTube channel and give free source code, because I upload all of the code to my GitHub repository and give the link in the description of this video. So if you have liked or learned something from this video, don't forget to subscribe and smash the like button. So have a nice day, because this is the end of the tutorial.